Hey folks, welcome back to Standby. Today we're going to be doing a breakdown series on my Haley Strategic D3 CR Heavy Chest Rig. All right guys, so let's get into it. This is my personal chest rig setup from Haley Strategic, the D3 CR Heavy. Now, as the name states clearly and loudly, it is a heavy platform. That means it is intended to be used with 308 magazines and 7.62 magazines. However, I just got from a hunting trip where I was using my AR, so I have my Magpul P mags in here. They do sit very loosely inside of these because of the size of the holes for the mags. However, as long as you're not bounding or running around, these aren't going anywhere. It's nice if you're just strolling or walking and hanging out. It sits in there just fine, so no complaints there. On the front of this, we're going to talk about the tiny pouches for your standard pistol magazines, your general mag pouch, and your small admin pouch. I've also attached a IFAC and a radio pouch here, which we'll talk about here. And overall, this is kind of my monster skeletal setup. I kind of do enjoy the multi-cam slash FDE look. So from the what would be my left wearing it, this is the most tactical UV9R Baofeng pouch. However, while it does fit UV5 and UV9Rs, it can also be extended here with the bottom strap, excuse the magazine, to fit a standard military 152 radio, which is super freaking awesome. And we do it often here at Standby. These things are all attached and affixed to this by a simple Velcro system, which is covered by this nice flat surface, so you're not going to get those male Velcro ends tearing up your clothes or making a bunch of noise, which is super freaking awesome to me. The other thing here is we have the little tiny general pouch. You can typically, I'd stick snacks, something kind of ridiculous in there. There's not a whole lot of room, which I personally don't like, so I've just kind of affixated one of these training thermobaric flashbang grenades, if you will. They also make them in smoke. If this is something you guys are interested in the future, please let us know in the comments. We could talk about these. While they do not possess the same firepower, if you will, as a law enforcement or military smoke grenade or flashbang, it does get the job done, gets the feel, and you can kind of train and expect to kind of get the effects of it as you would in a real world circumstance. Moving over to what would be my right is the big admin pouch. Now, I really like this pouch due to the fact that it has a clear plastic cheat sheet area. So if you are a military or law enforcement guy and you have some things that you need, some data on cards, flash cards, and you just want to look at them, you could pop this down and view them with ease, hands off. Now, I just have a hunting permit that I used in here so I could flash it if I had to. No big deal. Keep it right in the rain in here. Most folks do with plate carriers. I keep one of my plate carriers, keep one in here, or one of my jacket pockets at work. If I need to jot something down, I don't want to look unprofessional being my phone. These are a godsend. I love them. Most military guys know about them. So this is where I keep mine. I keep three pens with me. I keep my Write in the Rain pen and a red annotation Sharpie. I like red. Red's easy to see. I know that if I write something in red, I'm making an addition to a note I've already made. And then another little cheat code I have. Write in the Rains do not like other ballpoint Bic pens. If you write with a Bic pen on this from Staples or wherever and then you close it, it runs. It's very, very runny. That's at least from my experience. You guys may have another one. But because of that, I found that these Sharpies ballpoint pens work really, really well at drying fast and staying there permanently, so I don't have to worry about things running down the inside of my Write in the Rain. I also am keeping just my standard Cloud Defense white light handheld, which we've talked about in the past. I keep it in there because if I'm wearing this, I'm gonna have another belt on, which I already have one. This is kind of gonna be a spare. Also helps that if for some reason this is to ND and put the light out, there's a very thick material here. You're not gonna see it. It's gonna get warm, blow the battery out, but at least you're not gonna give away your location. The pistol mags on the front are really cool because I can keep a standard Glock 17 9mm mag in here like they're intended for, but they are the perfect size to retain a multi-tool or a handheld white light flashlight, and it's not going anywhere, especially if you have the Theorem clip on it. It's going to stay there and not move. Moving on to the final portion of what I want to talk about on my rig is my personal IFAC that I also have on my Haley Strategic duty belt is the Feral Concepts Generation 1 Roll 1. Now, I like this for multiple reasons. One being you can grab it with either hand, left or right. So if you lose a hand or an arm or it goes down due to an injury, you can get to this with either hand very simply, and it works as such. You can just remove the retention band, stick your fingers in there and loosen it up, and you just yank this guy out, and it's all bound up inside of this nice material with Velcro, and you can open it, and it's very neatly organized. I'm not going to go into the whole IFAC breakdown in this video, but as you can see, I keep a Sharpie for annotating times on tourniquets if I apply one to myself or a partner. I also have vented chest seals, hemostatic gauze, and your North American Rescue goodies all across the board. This is a really, really cool one. I like this a lot. The form factor and modality is my favorite because on my belt, I have this flipped upside down. So if you sit in a vehicle, it gives you good lumbar support, and you're not really going to break your back if you're sitting for long hours. So anyway, that's going to be the breakdown on my Haley Strategic Heavy Chest Rig. If you guys like it, let me know. If you have any questions, go ahead and comment, like, and subscribe. Appreciate you guys. See you on the next one.
Cut! Wow. Outstanding. That's crazy.